On the screen, we are everywhere. The best online Liberian platform you have. Make the best use of it. My name is Frank Adams, and I endorse this channel.
This is Creative Minds a Television, prefers to be called KMTV for short. We are in Pinesville City, to be exact, AOWA Junction. This time around is a dedication program, very exciting one. Some of the guests have already started arriving, and it's the Jadmeut Meds Solution. That's the as far as history is concerned, the first medical diagnosis center in the Republic of Liberia, exclusively on the stewardship of the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation of Liberia. You're listening to Culture True, and behind me, you also see the Director General of NASCOP in person of Dewitt Evan Bamus, and the Deputy Yan Tuan is also here along with other guests. Earlier on, we saw the arrival of the board chair of NASCOP, in person of a former Commerce Minister, Miata Beslow. So today we'll be bringing to you the dedicatory ceremony here. And President Johnson Sirleaf, outgoing president of this republic, will be dedicating this wonderful structure. Two of them, the nexus, right next the crossroads. And it will be a fascinating program. The other dignitaries are here. I'm here with my crew. I have my colleagues, Sheila Ebor. She's here. Aminanta Masale is also here. And I also have with me Ernestine Cooper. She's here. Augustus Walker, Amos Gozau. We are all here together to make this program a success. And this is indeed a splendid crew. Let me see how best I can get to some of my colleagues here as we go about with this wonderful and fascinating program. Wherever you are, you're watching KMTV Live. I have one of my colleagues, and she's no other person but in person of Sheila Ebor. Sheila, welcome to KMTV.
Thank you very much.
Welcome so much.
Yes, thank you very much.
We're here for this wonderful occasion. You're observing some of the guests arriving. Where's your own take? How do you feel about the program?
Well, I think that the program is very exciting, and I think that it's a good thing that NASCOP has finally built and kicked off 2018 with a wonderful investment. At least they have built a medical center that we can use to diagnose sicknesses. You know, in the past, like Ebola came, a lot of people were not able to diagnose whether they had Ebola or not. A lot of people died deaths that weren't related to Ebola. But right now, with this diagnosis center, now we can now identify issues regarding to health problems, and then people don't have to die for nothing. So we are very happy, and today we have some guests who have already arrived. And right now we see the head of Pinesville City Corporation, the mayor, she has just arrived also. We have the Deputy General of NASCOP, and we have the Director of NASCOP also. And we also have the Chairman of NASCOP, who is already here, Honorable Bessolo. So we are very excited. It's an exciting location.
Okay, we hope to get back to you later. You just watch and listen to the likes of Sheila Ebor. More guests are arriving. Members of the Folk Estate as well, they are arriving. And like she said, the head of the Pinesville City Corporation, as you know, Pinesville City is one of the newest and best in terms of development cities in the Republic of Liberia. Shebeck Gibson, she just arrived. Later on our camera will see how best to capture her. I see the arrival of the Vice President of the President of Liberia. And I see him now shaking hands with one of his colleagues, Otavin Williams, along with his crew, officials of the Press Union of Liberia, and members of the PEL are also part of this occasion. They just arrived, and more guests are arriving onto this stage, and we are waiting the dignitaries. Perhaps the president-elect will be here to grace this occasion, but as far as we know, the outgoing president will be doing the dedication. And we've seen Nathaniel Banks. He's here.
Happy New Year.
He's just arriving onto this one. Let's see if we can get to him. Nathaniel Banks. Let's see, moving back pretty good. So we just kind of moved to him. He's been ushered. But later on, we hope to see how best we can get one or two chip chats, one or two words of statements from him, including other officials of NASCAR. Culture Troop also here. They are contributing as well to this occasion. And wherever you are watching KMTV live here in Paintsville City. And someone may say, what are we here for? We are here for another fascinating, a wonderful ceremony. You know, the Ebola, like my colleague said, exposed the weakness of the health system. So in order to help revamp the system, in order to ensure that the people of this country help to equip and revitalize the health system, this is one of them, this beautiful structure. That's a diagnosis center. It will help in a long way where that people will not be able to go out of this country in terms of identifying sicknesses like heart disease, cancer, and whatever. They will just have the opportunity to come here and check whatever disease they may have and whatever treatment can be made possible. And I think this is actually rewarding. And all on the courtesy, and come courtesy, of the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation, NASCOP. NASCOP also constructed the building that is hosting the Liberia Revenue Authority. And what is fascinating about this project is that this project is exclusively funded by the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation, here the government of Liberia, without external support. And so this is indeed very remarkable. The last time we saw a similar thing was the Central Bank of Liberia. The CBL constructed a modern headquarters on Ashmont Street, and it was funded exclusively by the Liberian people, the taxpayers' money. And this is the second. I hope if Liberians can do that in the coming time, wonderful initiatives can help to make this country move forward. So I'll see how best I can talk to my colleague Ernestine, Ernestine Cooper. Ernestine is also here, and to grace this occasion, more dignitaries are arriving. Ernestine, welcome. I see you here for this occasion, and you look so overwhelmed already. You're so happy to see this gesture.
Sure I am. And I want to say a big thank you to the NASCAR family for this initiative. Thank you to the board of chairmen, that's Honorable Miata Barcelo and her team, Director General DeVern, that's Stuart Vaughn Barmars, and the Deputy Director, Mr. Yan D. Twyan, for this hard work that they have done for the people of Liberia. Like we know in the past, this is not the first initiative for Liberians. The Central Bank of Liberia was built. It's a Liberia funded initiative, and NASCAR is here again. They have another building that LRA is renting, and today they are dedicating a diagnosis center for Liberia. It's a privilege for Liberia because we won't have to fly abroad, carry our families to other places to get diagnosed or sicknesses that they have with. But we are very happy, and we say bravo to the NASCAR family for this initiative, and we pray that the doctors who will come here to work, God will work with them, that they will be able to diagnose our sicknesses and that we will be able to treat our own sicknesses here in Liberia. So I say bravo to the NASCAR family. Thank you for your hard work.
Thank you so much. We'll get back to you later. That's Ernestine Cooper giving her own take here concerning this remarkable initiative. KMTV Live here in Paintsville City, ERW Junction to be exact. And we are covering this dedicatory ceremony. More guests are still arriving. According to information, we should be starting around 3:30 local time. And if you may recall, today happens to be the first celebrations marking the inauguration program. President-elect George Weah, along with outgoing president Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, they were at the Central Mosque in Central Monrovia, where intercessory program was held, and President Johnson Sirleaf and President-elect George Weah, along with his entourage, they were there, and the grace that occasion And we understand that they are currently at the Jokpentown General Market. Another ceremony is taking place there. And that one is all about motivating your local, that's Liberian-owned businesses, looking at the creativity, the arts in the area of building and promoting Liberian-owned businesses. So many products produce, if you see some of them, it's very, they are very, very amazing indeed. And Liberians are actually trying to make sure that they take back the economy, implementing the Liberianization policy as well. We're hoping that that can come to fruition. So President Johnson Sirleaf and President-elect George Weah are at that program. Right after that, they will be coming here to this venue to do the dedication of this wonderful structure. Yeah, on tomorrow, as we are told, and there will be a football match and also honoring program of President Johnson Sirleaf. And so that match and that program is also in commemoration of the inauguration ceremony. And on Sunday, there will also be a Thanksgiving service, all a package for the inauguration. And on Monday will be the biggest, where Africa's first female president, Nobel laureate, Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, will be turning the mantle of authority over to George Weah, the first African and world best to be president of this wonderful republic. And so he will be turning over, taking the seat, the mantle of authority, and I mean, along with, as far as history is concerned, Liberia's first female vice president, Chief Senator Joelle Howard Taylor. They have the mantle of authority. They have a very huge task. The expectation so very high because Liberians have been awaiting, especially people from the grassroots level, the young people, they've been anxiously awaiting a new government, a government on the Coalition for Democratic Change, formerly CDC, Congress for Democratic Change. So this has come to pass. What are some of the things that they intend to do is what Liberians are anxiously waiting to see. Perhaps we can wait for the 100 days in office. Perhaps we can wait for 200 or the first 6 months. But whatever the case is, Liberians will be anxiously waiting to see in terms of what the incoming government can offer the people of this country. And basically, people are talking about job empowerment. I'd like to move back to my colleague, Sheila. Some of the things that Liberians may be anticipating from the incoming government after the inauguration on Monday. People are talking about youth empowerment, job creation. What do you think?
I think that after the inauguration, most Liberians are going to get jobs, especially with the fact that we have now, UNASCOP has now established, erected this building, this Jamal Med Solution. A lot of jobs will be available because they will need expertise. They will need people that know a little bit about medicine. So qualified librarians can be opportunity to participate in this benefit. So we are very happy about it, and we think that inauguration is a good thing, and it will bring empowerment for the youth.
Expectation is also high amongst the young people. You have any word of caution to them, the young people? Their expectations are high that they will get jobs, etc., etc.
Yes, it's good to have high expectations, but also I would encourage the young people to be aware that even though there are jobs available, you have to be qualified for those jobs. So what you should do in the meantime, you should make sure that if you're going to school, continue going to school, make sure you further education. If you are working, take your job very seriously. And also don't think that the government is going to be the one to bring jobs to you. You have to be qualified for those jobs. So yes, you can have high expectations, but don't be surprised if you don't have a job because you are not qualified. So build yourself up first before you look up towards the government. So that's what I would advise the youth.
Thank you for your analysis. We'll get back to you later. Earlier on, we saw the arrival of Councillor Ablai Gilebeku Williams. She just arrived here. Deputy Justice Minister, formerly of the Bureau of Immigration, that's the Liberia Immigration Service, formerly the Bureau of Immigration and Naturalization. She also served at the level of the Liberia Reconstruction, that is the LRRC to be exact, a Resettlement Commission, that's the LRRC. She's now at the Justice Ministry. She also here to grace this occasion. I tell you earlier on, this is very remarkable. I see Kletu Sia, formerly of the Information Ministry, is also here. Perhaps one of the members of the board of UNASCOP is here also to grace this occasion. As a matter of fact, this particular initiative is taking place under the stewardship of the board chair, Miata Beslow, former Commerce and Industry Minister. So that's a wonderful job she did on her own tenure, and along with the board of directors and that of Dewitt Vembamus, who happens to be the Director General of the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation of Liberia. Wherever you are watching KMTV, that's Creative Minds and Television, the young people of this country, they are moving to higher heights, trying to inform Liberians in whatever way it is, professionally, they are trying to inform the people of this country, and they put their arts together creative-wise, and this is what you're watching here, that's KMTV, and we are bringing this to you. We've been bringing several other happenings across this republic, all in my making show to inform, educate, and entertain the Liberian people. The music in the background, the cultural troupe, they're also doing their part, while guests are still arriving here for the dedication of the Jamil Meds Solution Medical Diagnostic Center. This particular center will be used to cater to several other sicknesses. And I see the very modern one. I'm very impressed. So are others. And we can do more of this in Liberia. We can do more of this. It's just a matter of being patriotic, nationalistic, having that love, care for each other. And this can be made possible. So KMTV is here. Let's see if we can get in touch with one or two individuals to see how best we can talk to them to give their own take concerning this all-important program. I am trying to see how best I can signal some of my colleagues to get some of the newsmakers while President Johnson Sullivan or entourage will shortly arrive here. Let's see if we can talk to the Vice President of the Press Union of Liberia, Otavin Williams, to get his take. He's coming to our microphone, always willing and ready to speak as a journalist. As a journalist, he's always prepared and willing. And as the ever-potent Vice President of the Press Union of Liberia, Otavin Williams. So welcome and happy New Year once more.
Many returns, and I hope we're going to have a pleasant and great 2018.
You are here, also one of the guests to grace this occasion. What's your impression? How do you think about this program, President?
Well, I think this is a welcoming development, and this is how we should have all of the government agency and entity behaving. When you have executive director, director generals, if they were behaving in this manner and form, I believe strongly we're going to have double development. So to see NASCO dedicating such a huge or huge and gigantic health center that will be able to curtail the many travels where people have to go to Ghana, go to Africa for further medical, this bring certain amount of relief to Liberians.
And this is actually laudable. And let's look at, because we're talking about inauguration, this program is as part of the inauguration ceremony. The president dedicating several other projects, completed and incomplete ones.
Well, I think there is this rush for legacy. So the president is trying to do everything possible to dedicate some of these edifices. But what is interesting is there is an ushering of a new government very soon, like in a daytime, few days. So obviously it means that the new government will see some of these issues as a match to be able to follow, to encourage some of those they're going to appoint in government to follow suit with those that were very constructive, those that were very developmental. And as you may be aware, this is our second time here in less than 6 years. Mm-hmm. The last time we're here, we're dedicating the NASCO Hall, the one the LRA using.
Sure.
And right close to it, this edifice is being constructed. So it's been developmental.
Let's backtrack a bit. What could be your own assessment briefly from the media perspective, talking about the Ellen Johnson Sirleaf government, which is gradually fading away?
Well, the only thing that I hold strong to this government is the issue of media relations. As far as I'm concerned, the government has not been fair with us. We have not had a very good media and government relations. So for me, the legacy of President Sirleaf media-wise, it's very damaging, and I think If we were to remember, we can only remember some of the terrible points. For example, the imprisonment of journalist Darlington Pilina, who was lied on by this government. And at the close of the day, he was acquitted. And today he's a free man. And because of the trauma, he cannot live in Liberia. The government was not fair to the media. The fact that the government even strangulated the media economically. So we strongly feel that the Ellen Johnson Sirleaf government is parting. But media relations was, I feel that it was a terrible legacy.
Yes. There were some laws passed in the interest of the media generally, looking at the Table Mountain Declaration, the freedom of information that is a law now, and other things. The only thing, there are some things that we can commend the government for in that direction.
The Table Mountain Declaration was just signed onto. Mm-hmm. It was then enforced, and they built the media took at the legislature in 2004. It was then also implemented. So as we speak, Decree 88 still remain in force. Those bylaws still remain on the book, and we cannot say the government did anything media-wise to give a leverage to the media in enjoying press freedom. But I said usually, and I'm going to say again, the level of press freedom we enjoy. It was a press freedom that veteran journalists that work for the Inkley Fraternity of Journalists in Liberia worked for. This is the freedom of Stanton P. Biden. This is the press freedom of the late journalist Charles Bain, who was killed on ERBC compound to dead. We cannot identify who slaughtered journalist Charles Bain. And this is the advocacy of all of the civil society leaders, including politicians, that stood firm at the time for us to enjoy free speech. So this is not a glory for President Sirleaf or government. So I can say to you, even the incoming government will not be able to turn their hands for us to go back to 1960 or 1982 in terms of press freedom.
This may be arguable from other perspective, but let's look at your own recommendation. What do you foresee of this government in terms of media relations?
The incoming government, I hope that the government will work with the media on a smooth note, believing that the government will be press friendly. Any attempt to subject the press, the government will be met with stiff and strong resistance. So we ask them to put their actions together. They must be media friendly, the environment must be created, and the media should not be economically strangulated. Like President Sirleaf did, she empowered the foreign media with state resources. That is the taxes we pay and media practitioners and media institutions. All of the taxes we pay to our government, she empowered the foreign media with it. I urge the George Weah-led government not to do same. They should collaborate with the local media. You have the KMTV. There's a new institution, and I'm proud to be on it today that is being Liberian owned. And these are the institutions that must be promoted. Do not go to the CNN. Do not go to the Al Jazeera, the BBC television, and spend billions of dollars on it. Empower the Liberian media, and the empowerment will be felt.
Thank you so much, Mr. Vice President. Hope to get you later.
It's a pleasure, and I hope we're going to have a pleasant and grateful 2018.
Thank you so much, Vice President of the Press Union of Liberia. Tough talking to Tavin Williams, giving his own thoughts about this program as well as the media relations on President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf-led government and what he envisaged for the incoming government, hoping that there will be a cordial and smooth working relationship with the media, empowerment and supporting Liberian media so that they can do their very best, and according to him, so that the issue of strangulation economic-wise of the media cannot be repeated. And in Liberia generally, we will indeed always be hoping for the best. David Vabamus, one of the brains behind this all-important program, along with his guests, they are here ushering them, and some of them are still arriving, along with our own colleagues as well. So he's still doing his work, and it's just not easy. You have to continue to work, and let's see, they will take their seats shortly. And Aminantad Masalade is on the other end of the broadcast, capturing all the wonderful scenes, as you can see here. And let's see if I can get back to my colleague while more guests are arriving. Let's see if I can get back to Sheila. Oh, Sheila, let's look at the program. We see so many guests arriving, and cultural tube and all of that. What do you expect from this program in terms of the success?
I expect the program to be successful. I'm waiting to see the president, the outgoing president, and see what she has to say regarding this building that has been erected. And I'm sure that I'm expecting to see the president-elect, George Manuel Weah. Probably he may be here, but I'm not sure yet. But I expect success from this program, and we have a lot of dignitaries. So this is something major that has happened in Liberia. Of course, we should have all the top dignitaries in Liberia present. So we just hope for the best. Let's watch and see.
The setting is still ongoing. You've seen the arrangement of the hall so far.
Yes.
What's your take?
Yes, the place is packed. As you see, people are still arranging. They're making spaces outside. So the program was supposed to start by 3 p.m., but now it's like it will start by 3. As you can see, we have more people coming because it's a very important event, very significant. So almost everyone wants to witness this. So it's very great. It's very significant in the history of Liberia. So we are very hopeful that it all will turn out very well.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Sheila. We get to Ernestine shortly as well. And like she said, this is very, very historic. I mean, very remarkable. All of the big guests are here. I see Health Minister Dr. Brennis Down is just arriving. And usually in an African attire, she's marching to the stand. And the Health Minister of this Republic, Dr. Brennis Down. And this is part of her mandate. As a matter of fact, you know, this is health related. A medical diagnosis center, can you imagine giving this to the people of Liberia through Health Watch? And I think that no other person that could be here should be the health minister, and she's here, and she's here in time. Patra Chuba also playing a part, entertaining the people there. What a wonderful one. I think, wow, the dances and so interesting. Wonderful, talented Liberian ladies, and they are also contributing to this all-important program here. You see the culture troupe dancing. I guess you can all you used to dance.
not really. I've never danced before my whole life.
But I think you see them dancing. What can you say about their performance?
And they are doing a wonderful job. They are entertaining our guests that are coming in here for the dedication, and they are doing pretty well.
Okay, thank you so much. They are doing pretty well. That's Ernestine Cooper, one of our own. She's here. And these are the faces you'll be seeing on KMTV very soon. They will be making their mark in the media landscape of this republic. So the culture troupe are playing their part. And the media journalists, they are also here performing their own role. We are here as well. Wherever you are, whatever continent you may be watching. And this is the biggest platform in the republic. And it's Creative Minds Television. KMTV, always there on time, in time, to bring it to you as you're watching it. I'm Julius Conton Augustus, Walker, Amos Kozau, Sheila Eba, the legs of Aminata Masale, the newest on the block. She's on the other end, capturing the scenes that you are seeing from the platform end. And Ernestine Cooper as well, she's also here. And we are here together, bringing to you what you actually watching. Yeah. As a reminder, if you just join us, we are bringing to you the dedication of the newest medical diagnostic center in the Republic of Liberia. That's the Jamaat Meds Solution, exclusively owned and constructed by the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation of Liberia. NASCOP is indeed doing fascinating things for the Liberian people, and this is actually remarkable. And so this is what is happening here. And some dignitaries, Miata Benslo, Hawking, one of the guests, one of the familiar faces in this Republic of Liberia. And so she just just walked here. Always when you see her, there's no doubt that you will see the president of this republic. And like we told you earlier, President Johnson Sirleaf is currently at Jokpentan Market as part of empowering Liberian-owned businesses. They are there to look at some of the creative things, products from the local business people in this republic. So she's there, and shortly she will be here. And I see the president of the African Methodist Episcopal University, Dr. Isaac Rowland, is here, and he's been ushered in by one of the ushers here, Dr. Isaac Rowland. He's marching majestically, smartly dressed. Walk up the guests, but maybe afterward, they are one way or the other trying to see where they can get their respective seats, and subsequently, we can talk to them and just to get their take, their own impression about this particular program. I'm so amazed about this project, and this is actually a rewarding one, and we have to give the plus to the NASCOM who actually constructed this, and it did one right next to it. That's the Liberia Revenue Authority, the LRA, the wonderful building. If you're not in Liberia, if you just arrive at ELW Junction, there is a wonderful, gigantic building, all glass, like, well furnished. And that's the NASCOM did similar. And again, NASCOM is doing this. This is very, very incredible. Awaiting President Johnson Sirleaf and other guests who will be arriving to this stage and to this particular hall. This building is very, very wonderful. I see the lights all over the place, and including where the ribbon will be cut. And I see the area. It's too colorful. I mean, this is very, very modern indeed. Classical one. I mean, just a classical building here. And we are hoping that we can get all of the technicians to see how best they can manage some of the modern equipment that they will be using here. And using the equipment wisely and maintaining them is another thing. And I know we have some of the best brains that will manage and take good care of the equipment that will be used for the medical diagnostic center. This is a concern, you know, because maintenance of things, a project of such nature, is actually the concern in this country, and it will always be the concern. So we are hoping that this particular project, this structure, can be well maintained. The culture troop, like we told you, are doing their part. They are performing very well. Executive mansion reporters are actually doing their best. They are just arriving here. Executive mansion reporters are just arriving while the culture troop are performing. I see the executive governor of the Central Bank of Liberia in person of Milton Weeks. Milton Weeks is arriving onto this place. The executive governor of the Central Bank of Liberia, Milton Weeks, is arriving and smartly dressed. Always. And just arrived here. That is an individual who takes care of money matter, especially from the end of the Central Bank of this Republic, who recently announced, if you can recall, about the issue of capital flight, money going out of the country, like he said, more than money coming into this country, which is very worrisome, and this has to be tackled according to him. And he also stated that they will make sure as much as possible for the issue of giving priority to the Liberian dollar banknote instead of giving priority to foreign exchange banknotes. And so we're hoping to see that can come to fruition. He just assumed that position, as a matter of fact. So he has more to do. It's a 10-year position, 5 years, and after that, he will continue if need be. We still want to speak with the Deputy Director General, but I see him. He has a lot to do. Yan Twain, he has a lot to do. Seeing how best, you know, we are the organizers of this program. So he's working around the clock to see, to read that his guests are actually seated and to put in place all of the finishing touches. So we just cannot get to him now, but perhaps we could do that later on. You see the ushers of NASCOM, they are actually doing their own best. Let's see if we can get to the Director General of NASCOM. Let's see if we can make our way to him to see, though he's still chip-chatting. We'll see if we can get a word or two from him, Dude from Bamus. After this consultation, we'll see how best we can talk to him. So welcome to KMTV. You did a wonderful job. Liberians are commending you. Welcome. Happy New Year.
Well, Happy New Year. Thank you very much.
Thank you for that great job. What do Liberian people expect from this organization?
Well, this is the first of its kind medical diagnostic center. And what this is going to do, now it's here, we have the diagnostic center that does any possible diagnostic in the world. It will tell you what's wrong with you, how are you, Steve? It will tell you what's wrong with you, we'll be able to diagnose us. We have the MRI, the CT scan, the mammogram, the x-ray, digital x-ray. We're going to, at some point, go into dialysis, but not right now. But this is a start. This is a first class, and it's what it's going to do is going to be a regional hub. And so now Liberia is going to be on the map for this. So now Liberians don't have to travel to Ghana or anywhere else to seek medical attention.
Did you get any support for the clarity's sake to do this?
From the who?
For clarity's sake, did you get any support to do this particular project?
When you say support, what do you mean?
Support, international support.
Oh no, this is all done by the Liberian people's money. This is the Liberian people's money at work.
You did a wonderful complex where the LRA is using and now you are doing this. What's the secret behind all of your good jobs?
Well, when you pay to do a piece of work, you do what you pay to do. And it takes commitment to country, vision. This is what we do.
Maintenance of the equipment that will be used. Are you concerned about that?
We all have extended warranty and we have secured proper maintenance and secured warranty for all the equipment.
Any final thing you'd like to say, sir?
I just like to say this is a wonderful day in Liberia and we're all happy. And thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome.
And that's the brain behind this wonderful initiative. You listen to him, first class, more than one, first of its kind in the Republic, and they have warranty. Warranted, I tell you for sure, for the equipment via here in terms of making sure that the maintenance of it, and you can have a first class diagnosis, whatever the case may be, and indeed you can make that possible. Former city mayor of Monrovia, Ophelia of Setuma, also just arrived here, and she was hugged or embraced by the director general of NASCOM. Still now, very shortly, we are waiting our President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf and our entourage, and they are the ones that this protocol is waiting for to commence this all-important program. We are here for the official dedication of the Medical Diagnostic Center, that's the Jamil of Meds Solution, the first in the Republic, first class, number one, as you listen to the Director General giving all of the praises to it. And once you have dedication and love for country, you can do more of what he did, like he said. So we have to continue to follow the full path of people of this country that continue to help in their weak way possible to contribute and show tangibles to the Republic of Liberia in terms of developing their own motherland. More guests are arriving, and as they are arriving, we make sure it's what we do, KMTV. You will see it on whatever means you're watching, whether in your homes, in your vehicle, using your mobile, whatever the case is, you will indeed see it. And we're talking about protocol now. And very shortly, we are receiving signals that President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, Africa's first female president, the individual, the astute individual who set the stage for Africans, for women on the continent, to ensure that they can equally, additionally realize their full potential in the democratic space. She challenged them recently, especially Liberian women, to ensure that they step up to the plate and take the necessary action so that they can move this country forward, so that their presence can be felt. And according to her, you have to stand up for something. Once you can stand up for something, indeed, you will be someone remembered at all times. But if you can't stand for something, you will be remembered for nothing. And her wonderful and most famous quotation, if your dream doesn't scare you, then it's nothing indeed. And so you have to think big. In other words, if you can remember our former president Charles Taylor, he said, you have to dream and think big. And she's saying, if your dream doesn't scare you, then it is not worth dreaming. And so, in other words, you have to think big, think about the many things in terms of moving the country forward. Think very big above yourself, positively, to ensure that you make things happen. Sir, welcome to KMTV. Happy New Year.
Thank you. Happy New Year.
Good last year. Just seeing you, sir.
Hey, you look fresh. Very running.
You look very fantastic as well.
Wonderful. Thank you, man. It's good seeing you.
We are for this wonderful program. What's your take, sir?
Well, it's part of the achievement of President Sirleaf. I can just describe it as fantastic, very wonderful. And we are proud that under the President's administration, we can arrive at such wonderful facility in our country. It's wonderful. It has changed the look of Paynesville and by extension Liberia. And we are grateful that under her administration, we can achieve so much in as much we still have more to do. But we are grateful.
Including incomplete projects have been dedicated. People are saying the president doesn't want to leave anything for the next government. She wants to carry out of the legacies.
You know, everything you do, people have something to say, you know. But I think it's good doing what she's doing because under her regime, she started these projects and she wants to be part of them as it has been unfolded. Take, for example, the airport, this one, and other projects that she dedicated. So we are happy being part of it. And seeing it coming to fruition is something you take pride in, and somebody takes pride in. And we are wonderful that she's dedicating this giant-sized project that have brought so much pride to our country. And there are more to be done, even after her administration. We believe the president-elect, after he should have been inaugurated on Monday, will continue the dedicatory ceremonies.
To backtrack a bit, looking at President Johnson Sirleaf's administration, from the end of media relations, you've in the information area. What can you say, sir?
President Sirleaf, if there is nothing to remember her for, she will be remembered when it comes to press freedom. You know and I know that as we speak, we do not have any political prisoner, let alone
some journalists that were jailed.
No, journalists that were jailed were not jailed arbitrarily by the government. They came in conflict with individuals. Take, for example, the former agriculture minister, Dr. Toh. So that was not a government issue. And they are individuals, they are Liberians. They have the right when they come in conflict with the law.
What's about the Darlington Pelinan case, the specific case of Darlington Pelinan? He was broadcasting on the air and they said he was carrying out hate messages. And he went to jail, but later on he was acquitted.
You said they said, so it means you are not quoting a soul. You said they said.
It was the government who took that particular decision. The government suing at the time and went to jail.
The issue of Darlington Pelinan, the government acted as per what transpired. So you know and I know that no one's above the law. Even if you are the president and you came in conflict with the law when you should have left office, the law that explained itself. So the issue of Darlington Pelinan, the law took its course.
Whatever the case is, can you say 100% in terms of percentage?
The more the government needed to have done, but the government has done more when it comes to press freedom, freedom of expression. I mean, having the atmosphere of journalists in Liberia being very cordial. You know that she received...
Just by closing some media institutions down.
There were no media institutions closed arbitrarily. They were closed on the basis of court order. And that's the way to go. And you want to mention NRB 24. That was as a result of a court order. And you know and I know that's the best way to go. So when somebody feels offended, they go to the court and let go in the bush. So the president received toss-up. She's too tall when it comes to press freedom and freedom of expression in Liberia.
Let's look at the health system. And Ebola came and exposed the weakness of the health system. Do we have this? Which may be one of the good results, like you said, the health system. What can you say?
Ebola came and surprised all of us. None of us knew about Ebola. In fact, we consider Ebola as an enemy to Liberia because when Ebola came, none of us knew exactly what's supposed to be done, what should have been done. So the president took leadership, and you're aware of that. The president wrote the word. The president, in fact, defied the projection made by the World Health Organization. And today, with the community involvement, we have what we have today as a victory for Ebola. Yes, we have some challenges in the health sector, and we're still growing. Today, because of that, you have the agency head of Atoba Nyenswa now. We never had that before. The National Health Agency of our country head of Atoba Nyenswa. So there were challenges. Not that it exposed it, but it also showed up what to be done in the future should something arise. So today we have a system now to battle down. When something should arrive tomorrow, there's something to battle that. So we can say we made some significant gains when it comes to the health sector. Today you have hospitals, clinics being constructed with health workers. Before now, my brother, health workers, particularly nurses, were making $60. Doctors were making $200. Today doctors are making more than $1,000. But it's not enough. Government needs to do more. And we believe the next administration will embark on an improvement when it comes to the health sector to take Liberia to where it's supposed to be.
Sincerely speaking, so in terms of to admit, what are some of the things that you think this government did not do well and that the next government should work on?
I think government did not create more jobs for the young people. I know she did some, but more needs to be done. Youth empowerment, we need to be bold about that. The president have said that over and again. Because when you have more people working, you have less problem. If you have less people working, you have more problem. Because there's an old adage that say, an idle mind is the devil's workshop. So the government did well, but she needed to have done more when it comes to youth empowerment. But we believe that the next administration will improve on what this government has done to employ more young people and attract more investment in the country that will attract the citizens to do more when it comes to job empowerment.
The exception of job and youth empowerment, what else you think you can remember? Can we say corruption? The president said this government failed on that.
This is the government that done more when it comes to corruption.
Just by branding corruption as enemy number one vampire.
Yes. Corruption is pandemic. It's not a rock city. And it's something that part of the human race. And you know, corruption is not just fought at the government level. And if you have to fight corruption, you must establish systems and institutions. That's why
they part of the systems. That's why there are all the anti-grab institutions. Only the smaller people have been affected in terms of action taking the others. As far as we know, they've been transferred to other areas.
No, what we know, this government has elevated corruption. It's a government in itself that announced when money or something goes wrong at an entity. It's not so bad. Take for example, GSE is part of the government. You have the auditing agency, it's also part of government. So if an audit is conducted and the result comes out, it's government that announced. Before now, you never used to hear these things yet.
What impact does it make when you have an institution and the enforcement is not being done, implemented?
No, the enforcement is done. Maybe the way we look at it. You know, something that has not happened in our country for a very long time. For those things to be 100% implemented, so now it takes time. You know, living like that, and then you come in to live that day for some time. This government, when it comes to corruption, has done extremely well. Yes, there are more that we need to do when it comes to corruption.
Because we need one president, one top government official that will punish
corruption. Abra problem. Matilda Parker. There are lots of them. And you know,
they're not in jail anymore.
No, but you have to follow the rule of law.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much.
We'll do more of that.
Thank
you so much. It's my pleasure. It's
the president,
pleasure.
Your boss is arriving now. That's all.
That's your president.
President of the Republic of Liberia. And you just watch and listen to exactly Abel Plaki, Director of Press at the office of President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. And very shortly, we see the arrival of President Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia. I see walking very fast to her. Motorcade is the original, I may say, the original person for this city, the city mayor in person of Chivette Gibson. She's moving to welcome President Johnson Sirleaf because, as you may well know, as far as protocol is concerned, this is indeed her own, her own city, her own operation area. Citizens of this republic waving that's the Vice President-elect Joel Howard Taylor, the belated birthday lady, just celebrated her birthday recently, and she said they were indeed trying to give back to this country. The Vice President-elect Senator of Bond County, that's Joel Howard Taylor, and I hope my has got me right. And see the entourage is wearing white, shaking hands, as well as applauding the cultural troop. As usual, very, 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 in her orange head towel, waving hands, and with dignitaries here. And I see also Senator Wise, Honorable is just here along with this entourage. So we're still waiting. That's the protocol. Right after this, perhaps we'll be seeing the Vice President-elect followed by President Johnson Sirleaf or the Speaker, whatever the protocol, make sure it to be, we bring that to you. And so, Vice President-elect Joel Howard Taylor from Bond County, she set a remarkable record that people say, hey, after starting from a First Lady of this Republic, and she went on to be a Senator of Bond County, Senior Senator as a matter of fact, won for the second time. And as we speak now, Vice President-elect of this Republic, first female Vice President. So can you imagine, this is indeed a wonderful occasion. We see more vehicles are coming here, and now that it's arriving very shortly, I see the head of the Liberia Revenue Authority, Freda Stewart Tamad, is coming, and this is not too far from her own area and the LRA. Freda Stewart Tamad, and she's marching here to this podium and also part of this program. So that's it there. More guests are arriving. They appears to be the President of the Republic. Let's see. As a matter of fact, she will indeed do the dedication, cutting the ribbon for this wonderful project here. That's the Jamil Meds Solution. That's the first medical diagnostic center in the Republic of Liberia. State of the art, as the Director General termed it. State of the art. Very remarkable. President Johnson Sirleaf, Africa's first female head of state. And President Johnson Sirleaf shaking hands, waving as a matter of fact. Shaking hands. Dilwood Fabamu is the head of NASCOP. Smartly dressed, always in an African attire. President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. She's smashing, doing extremely well. And she will indeed complete this all-important task on Monday at the Samuel Kayode Sports Complex. She's shaking hands, walking. Let's see, they're at the best. They are also in similar attire. History making president of this republic, the world at large, Nobel laureate. Got so many accolades. And so very shortly we'll move to the podium where this all-important program will begin. The Master of Ceremony is Deputy Director General of NASCOP. He's not a person, but Nyan Twangwe. So let's move now to the podium.
Thank you. Hey, Terupuro, cut up. Asatu, Terupuro, cut up. Your Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia, Vice President-elect, Honorable Joel Howard Taylor, management and staff of NASCOP, and the board, the chairman of the board of directors, cabinet ministers here present, our well-deserved beneficiaries of NASCOP, our invited guests, on behalf of the management of NASCOP, we would like to welcome you, and we are very happy to have you with all of your busy schedule in our midst for this historic and groundbreaking dedication of the Jumale Medical Solution Diagnostic Center dedication program. Today, January 19, 2018, at about this time in the city of Paintsville. We will now begin our program with an invocation by Reverend Julius Waze K. Williams I, Senior Pastor of First United Methodist Church. Reverend Williams.
Praise the Lord. God is good. And all the time, surely He is good. The Bible declares in Psalm 127, unless the Lord builds the house, those who build it labored in vain. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. We thank you for being so good to us, God. Thank you for being good to our nation. This afternoon, we thank you for wisdom. Thank you for financial resources. Thank you for the will, O God, to build. We commit this ceremony into your hands. We pray your presence here with us, O God, today. Thank you again. We worship and we bless you this day. And in Jesus' name we pray.
Thank you, Reverend Williams. Thank you, Reverend. My name is Nyan Twain Jr. I'm the Deputy Director General for NASCOP. I will be your host today. Sorry, I didn't introduce myself first. We will now have a welcome statement by Honorable Severt Gibson, the Mayor of Painesville. Madam Gibson.
Oh, you're already here. Sorry. I didn't
imagine. No problem. We should just continue. Her Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia. Vice President-elect, Honorable Jewel Howard Taylor, Honorable DeWitt Von Bommus, Director General of NASCORP, Chairman of the Board of Directors, Madam Miata Beslow, Officials of Government present, invited guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, members of the Fourth Estate. At this historic time, I bring you greetings from the residents of the city of Painesville. It gives me great pleasure to be here for the official dedication of this facility as it marks another important milestone within our municipality. The National Social Security and Welfare Corporation has successfully completed the construction of a modern medical facility which will cater to the health needs of our residents of Painesville and occupants of other municipalities. Today, Madam President has come forth with another historic contribution, which demonstrates her keen devotion to the city of Painesville. The completion of a newly constructed medical facility at the ELWA Junction is extraordinary. Painesville mirrors similar traits as other cities with rapid urbanization, which is accompanied by a host of problems, including growth in urban poverty, and an increasing demand for basic services such as healthcare and installation of infrastructure. NASCORP, you have tackled one of our acute shocks in the city by constructing this beautiful state-of-the-art edifice. You saw the needs of our residents. You are a partner who's solution-driven and instrumental to the city as we strive for cutting-edge, innovative ways to build resilience for our residents. This contribution plays a pivotal role in the healthcare delivery system of the city of Painesville. I stand here today and extend heartfelt appreciation to Madam President, Mr. Von Bommus, Madam Miata Beslow, and the board of NASCORP. And again, I will welcome you to the city of Painesville.
Sorry for the inconvenience. Madam Mayor, that was a very beautiful speech, and we hope that we'll have a copy so that we can put it in our archives
as a compliment. Thank you so much. We are very sorry for the outage of power. You know, this is a newly constructed building. Probably there was some shop here. We proceed. We will at this time, but he will have to explain to us why the power went. We will have this time a presentation of the center and hand over keys to the Director General by Mr. Joe Mulba, the head of the Muslim Group Incorporated, who was the main contractor of the building. Mr. Joe Mulba.
And you will explain.
Our Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia. Her Excellency, Madam Joy Howard Taylor, President, Vice President-elect of the Republic of Liberia. Officials of government present, the leadership of NASCOP, members of the diplomatic corps present, members of the Fourth Estate, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. We are most grateful to the Almighty God for giving us this opportunity as Liberians to serve our country. When our company was selected after a very tough bidding process to build this historic center, the first of its kind in the Republic of Liberia, we took it not just as a project, but as an opportunity to serve our country in this time. For when we look back during the Ebola time, how our health system suffered, we say it is not an opportunity to be part of this process. Over the years, 2 years, we have worked with the leadership of NASCOP to build this center. In this public manner, I will say, I have worked with many people in the private sector, in the public sector, but I must say here, we are most grateful to Honorable DeWitt Van Bommels. He did not only award us a project, he also served as a mentor. Some days it was rosy, some days he spanked us, and it was for the right purpose. And I said to him a few days ago, Chief, congratulations and thank you. He said, for what? I said, because if you had not stood as a father, we couldn't have been where we are today. Sir, we thank you again. This project, concerning the nature of it, a state-of-the-art medical diagnostic center, it was a team project where we held a lot of teams. Please permit me to name a few of the teams. The engineering department of Muslim Group Incorporated was the lead contractor of the project. The project consultant consists of two groups, Mosa Consult from Ghana and Amlet from Liberia. Both teams work with us around the clock to make this project a success. The interior design specialist, IC Interior, headed by Madam Annex Cooper, high-tech consultant, headed by Robbie Arnold, a Liberian, responsible for the fire alarm, CCTV, and hydrant system of the building. The IT team was headed by NASCOP IT team, headed by Leonardo Maxwell. When the equipment specialist came, they gave us terms and conditions for the AC system, the central AC system in the building, and the only closest people we could get was FlexiSpace from Ghana. They work with us from Christmas Day to New Year Day to present. No sleeping until we got the building powered. We also work with USG, Universal Hospital Group from Ghana, and ODEF from Netherlands. They send their experts, and I must say it was a great learning curve for us. They came and taught us as Liberians how to do it ourselves. And indeed, we did it, and when they returned, they said congratulations to Liberians for they have made it. We had top international, the elevator engineer headed by Mr. Wu, a Chinese, who have worked with us to make the project a success. The electrical engineering consultant was headed by two professional Liberians, Mr. Gregory Kier and Mr. Joseph L. Grams, along with Mosons Group Incorporated Electrical Department. In this joyous celebration of dedication, please permit me to congratulate the leadership of our country for affording us Liberians the opportunity to be part of nation building. We will say here that over the years, we have gone out there, we have worked. Some places we failed, some places we succeeded, we learned from our mistake, and I can say the Liberian professional community society is prepared to take on nation building. At this junction, I will call on Honorable DeWitt Van Bommels, Director General of the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation, for the key to this beautiful health center. Please put your hands together for Honorable DeWitt Van Bommels as he comes up. Sir, we thank you for the opportunity given us, and we avail ourselves to do more in the future. On behalf of Mosons Group Incorporated and the entire team, I present to you the keys.
Good afternoon, everyone. At this point, may I call Madam Miata Beslow, Chairman of the Board of Directors of NASCO. Madam Beslow, as the keys of the facility have been turned over to me, I turn them over to you for onward transmission to Madam President. Thank you.
Madam, here we are.
Thank you, Joe. Thank you, Madam Beslow. I like the way Liberian contractors usually end a statement. We look forward in the future to doing more. That's a loaded comment. All right. We will now call on Mr. Christopher McBarrow, the Investment Development Specialist at NASCO, to do the introductory remarks and present some little fact sheet to you. Mr. McBarrow. Thank you.
Madam President, Your Excellency, Mrs. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, Madam Vice President-elect, Madam Jewel Howard Taylor, members of the legislature and judiciary, here present, cabinet ministers, here present, Mr. Director General, Mr. DeWitt von Bumbles, the Chairman of the Board of Directors of NASCORP, Madam Miata Beslow, and members of the board, management and staff of NASCORP, NASCORP's guests, members of the Fourth Estate, ladies and gentlemen. We've come once again to dedicate yet another infrastructure development project, the Jamali Mess Solutions Medical Diagnostic Center, being undertaken by the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation, NASCORP. The investment division is indeed grateful to the President, Her Excellency Mrs. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, for appointing capable leaderships to govern the affairs of this corporation over the last 12 years. This has afforded us the opportunity to conceptualize our vision and see it come to fruition during this period. In 2006, the investment portfolio of NASCORP was a mere $3.7 million in real estate asset, solely comprising of the Wentown Housing Project initiated by the late President Samuel Kanyan Doe, coupled with long outstanding loans in the tune of about $1 million due substantially from GOL and the rest from private individuals and business corporations. 12 years on, from 2006 to present, the corporation's investment portfolio has grown from $4.7 million to a little over $50 million United States dollars, as described in the following portfolio asset categories: real estate and real properties assets, which amounts to $33.5 million, financial assets, $15 million, loans and guarantees, $1.7 million. Our real estate and real properties include the NASCORP House next door, presently on a lease to the Liberian Revenue Authority, the Alba Kanga Commercial and Residential Complex in Grand Bassa County, comprising of a four-story commercial building and an apartment building containing 8 apartments, which both buildings previously were leased to the Buchanan Renewable and subsequently to ArcelorMittal. We also have a 16-bedroom guest house in Lofa County, a 10-bedroom guest house in Kakata, Mount Gibi County, and various prime land in and around Monrovia for future development purposes, as well as this diagnosis center, which we are here to dedicate today. Our financial assets, which are equity shares and fixed income deposits, include the following: at market value, 4.2 million shares in the Liberian Bank for Development and Investment, the LBDI, $3.9 million shares in the Dual Development Corporation, 1 million shares in the Pan-African Homes, that is the Omega Village Project, another $500,000 in Shelter Afrique, another $500,000 in EcoBank Transnational Incorporated, and fixed income deposits, which totals $5.2 million at various local commercial banks. Our loans and guarantee comprise solely the amount of $1.5 million extended to the Nimba Rubber Company to mitigate a potential unrest by workers and small farmers. Apart from our investment, NASCO over the years also acquired capital assets. We, a little over a month ago, we dedicated our first newly built regional office in Kakata, Magiri County. And under construction on 24th Street, you will see that we are building our first national corporate headquarters. Apart from these capital assets, our corporation extended helping hands to our communities through our CRS program, corporate social responsibility programs, and major among those was the NASCO Village in Jatono Town, in collaboration with the National Housing Authority, where we built 165 housing units to be sold to low-income Liberians. Today, that project is being managed by the National Housing Authority and was funded 100% by the National Social Security and Welfare Corporation. Ladies and gentlemen, none of those projects previously mentioned, including this medical diagnosis center being dedicated here today, were accomplished by mere luck or magic. This is a direct result of a vision conceptualized, project feasibility and cost analysis, business model development, and the many stressful days and sleepless nights. So whilst this medical center will contribute immensely to the nation's health and social benefits, may I humbly remind us all that this is an investment project. Therefore, the investment division is mandated to ensure reasonable returns on this investment within a reasonable time frame. There is absolutely no way this can be accomplished if we all, especially our government officials, expect services rendered to us and our extended families by this center to be free of charge. Of course, our country's per capita income level will indeed be considered during this center's pricing strategy and structure. I believe free is not a price. And although free services may be highly altruistic by nature, free services definitely cannot maintain, sustain, and ensure recovery on this major investment. For most of us, we are already aware of the alternative costs, including foreign travels, in securing modern and accurate diagnostic services in the absence of this center. We therefore solicit the cooperation of us all. Again, the investment division extends sincere thanks to Her Excellency Mrs. Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia, members of the Board of Directors, both present and former, the Director General, Mr. Dewitt Fumbambu, former Director General, Mr. Francis Nkaba, for creating an enabling environment where our expertise and professionalism can and has indeed flourished over the last 12 years. To the rest of the NASCO staff, including the Deputy Director General, the Chief Financial Officer, the Comptroller, all Assistant Director Generals, and all other staff of this esteemed corporation, the Investment Division, thank you all for your contribution and support. To the contractors and consultants, which we are constantly engaged with in seeing this project develop to what it is today, our personal and sincere appreciation. I thank you very much for according me your undivided attention.
I want to go into the
So whilst I'm still at this podium, I would like to call Dr. Odoi, Adrian Nee Odoi. Dr. Odoi is our project consultant for this project. He has a vast experience, over 35 years of experience in diagnostic services. He is the head and owner of Akai House Clinic in Accra, Ghana. And his services are extended to mostly the diplomatic corps and private NGOs and organizations, as well as the people of Ghana. When we started this project, we were very happy to engage Dr. Odoi to help us, particularly with the medical aspect of this structure, the laboratory, the imaging, and what have you. And he has been very, very helpful to us. So at this time, please join me in welcoming Dr. Adrian Nee Odoi to the podium.
Good afternoon, Your Excellencies. This is Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Ghana of Liberia. Forgive me. I'm a bundle of nerves today, and I'm sure you'll understand. Your Excellency, Madam Jewel Howard Taylor, Vice President-elect of the Republic of Liberia, Chairperson, Director General, members of the board, staff of the National Social Security Corporation of Liberia, cabinet ministers, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. It is indeed an honor and a pleasure to be here this afternoon speaking as the consultant for this medical project which is about to be completed. It stands as one of my proudest personal and professional moments, and I would like to thank you all.
You see standing right there, for little technical reasons of constant supply of power and not it being able to get in at this time, but they're here. We're talking a Toshiba Achillion detector, a Rowe Ultra CT scan, a Prime Open MRI machine that is already installed in the building, Canon DR X-ray machine, a mammogram machine. There will be mammography here. We'll be doing mammograms here. Ultrasound machine, electrocardiograph machine, and so forth and so forth. And an extended laboratory that will be upstairs, as you will eventually see. The addition of this state-of-the-art facility to our national healthcare system will complement and provide much-needed high-level laboratory and imaging diagnosis to thousands of our citizens who unfortunately die as a result of common undiagnosed diseases. It will also save huge amounts of money spent to travel abroad for treatment. This facility will further enable technology and specialized skills transfer to local Liberian medical technicians, contributing to the capacity building as well as encourage and attract the attention of Liberian medical professionals abroad to return home. May I now take this opportunity to recognize and give special thanks to those who assisted to get this facility to what it is today. My immense thanks and gratitude go to Dr. Adrian Odoyi again, for it's been a long time coming. Many meetings, many meetings and talks. The Musons Group, Madam Miata Beslow, and the entire board of directors, who we know the fights we had, but we succeeded. The senior management of NASCOP, thank you very much. Mr. Christopher Badboro and his investment team, who were the gophers, they did the legwork daily, including Mr. Dimamu Giddings, Mr. Amadou Dole, who spent sleepless nights here, at least in the last 3-4 weeks, to get this to where it is. Mrs. Ines Taylor Cooper, the interior designer. I think they live here. You people probably have a room in here or something. I don't know. And our bankers, the GT Bank, for facilitating all our LCs, the GN Bank, LBDI, and IB Bank. We are grateful for your partnership. Madam President, as you take leave of us, we are cognizant of the challenges and appreciate the achievements of your administration, and no doubt certain that history will affirm your sacrifices and stalwart leadership. This medical center contributes to the achievement of one of the key development goals your administration so ardently has worked towards. This further manifests the resilience of the Liberian people and the possibilities of our collective efforts towards development in the future. As we commence the new administration, Madam Vice President, incoming Vice President, we want to state publicly our full and unequivocal commitment and loyalty to our incoming President, His Excellency Ambassador Senator George Manawia, and to our incoming Vice President, Her Excellency Senator Jewel Howard Taylor, and hope for a very cordial working relationship, as we have been so privileged and honored to have enjoyed over the years. We extend you best wishes, Madam President, for a successful, peaceful, and productive retirement. I thank you.
Thank you, Honorable DJ. We will call on behalf to make remarks on behalf of the board of directors, the co-chair of the board, Honorable Kretu Seer. Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf,
President of the Republic of Liberia, Her Excellency, Madam Joelle Howard Taylor, Vice President-elect of the Republic of Liberia, the Honorable Mayor of the City Corporation of Painesville, senior government officials here present, Madam Myatta Beslow, Chairman of the Board of Directors of NASCAR, and members of the board, Honorable Dewitt Van Bommels, and members of the senior staff of NASCAR, Dr. Adrian Odoi, and members of the RK House, prelate and members of the clergy, members of the Fourth Estate, senior management and members of NASCAR family, ladies and gentlemen. It is with humility that I carry out this task on behalf of the chair of the board, to whom we owe our utmost respect for her diligence, professionalism, and hard work. This corporation and the board would not be here today basking in this glory had it not been the hands-on approach of Madam Beslow. We salute you, Madam Chair. The National Social Security and Welfare Corporation has been one of the shining examples of the success story of this government, as every nook and corner of Liberia smells the aroma of the delicious services which NASCAR renders the Liberian people, especially employers and employees who are covered under our pension plan. Today, because of NASCAR, with strong support from President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf and her government, there is less anxiety for those employees, both in the private and public sector, as regards your pension and benefits. To continue to allay the fears and anxiety of those recovered, NASCAR had to create or find creative ways to ensure that the financial well does not run dry, and that monies will be available at all times to meet retirees' benefit, which is the core function of NASCAR. The idea for the construction of a medical diagnostic center took center stage approximately 3 years ago, when members of the Accra House of Ghana, headed by Dr. Odoi, made their presentation to the board of directors, detailing the numerous benefits accruing to NASCAR and the people of Liberia. The board of directors got fully sold out on the idea and gave its fullest cooperation to management. And today, what 3 years ago was a dream, has been actualized as a result of commitment, dedication, and hard work. We want to thank Mr. Dewitt Van Bommels and the management of NASCAR for their fire-startedness in ensuring that this vision is fulfilled. While it is true that the Diagnostic Center is an investment, it is also true that it is a critical intervention in the healthcare system of our country. This Diagnostic Center will fill the gaps in our healthcare system, especially detecting through diagnosis critical and life-threatening ailments, example, heart diseases, lung diseases, stroke, liver diseases, cancer, including breast cancer, etc. Our citizens will no longer carry the burden of traveling to other countries, including Ghana, South Africa, India, USA, etc., to diagnose their conditions. The little foreign exchange, which usually attends such travels and diagnostic services, will remain here in Liberia. And nationals from other countries will come here for such services because of the affordability of our center. We want to encourage insurance companies that are involved in health insurance to collaborate with us and take advantage of this market. Annual physical examinations, which are very essential and which become taxing for some government officials and others in our society, can be undertaken by this diagnostic center at lower fee. We encourage international organizations such as the WHO, USAID, UNDP, etc., to collaborate and utilize this center so that the cost of seeking services by the ordinary people will be lower and will be affordable. Noam Chomsky says, and I quote, "Social security is based on the principle that you care about other people. You care whether the widow across town, a disabled widow is going to be able to have food to eat and to be healthy." Madam President, Madam Vice President-elect, the Jamali Medical Solutions Center is going to be state-of-the-art, but also a beacon of hope to our people. As Liberians pass around and through these facilities, especially workers under the Social Security scheme will see what their contributions have done and are doing. A giant-sized NASCOP house occupied by LRA, side by side with Jamali Medical Center, that other nothing power, that's something. Social Security is a covenant that should not be broken. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I know we see somebody was gossiping about you. Say, man, a crew man, then you turn around, you're former information minister. So we are not surprised. Okay, we will now invite a member of the House Standing Committee on State Enterprises. Honorable Peno or Honorable Ellen Ato here. Okay. We will now invite the Honorable Minister of Health, Dr. Brennis Dan, to make a remark.
Her Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, the President of the Republic of Liberia. Her Excellency, Madam Vice President-elect, Madam Joelle Howard Taylor, the Director General of NASCOP, and the entire management team, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the House Committee on SOEs, I'm honored to address such a wonderful gathering today. On behalf of my colleagues, I hereby extend our gratitude and appreciation to all of you who made this project a success. I want to say thank you for this center, in as much as it is a commercial one, but it is something that is needed by the society. I also want to express my thanks to the director of NASCOP for giving us this opportunity to be here today. I'm sorry that the chairman is not here today, Honorable Zopena, so I'm here today to proxy on his behalf. I want to say thank you to everybody, And congratulations to the team for work well done. Thank you.
That was Honorable Ellen Atore. Now the Minister of Health.
Thank you. Yeah. Madam President, the Vice President-elect, other members of the High Table, government officials here present, members of the Diplomatic Corps, partners, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. The Liberia health sector continues to grow since our national conflict and post-Ebola. Today, WHO estimates that the average Liberian female lives about 63 years old and the male 62, compared to 43 and 42 in the 90s. That means 20 years over the decade. It means that Liberians are living on an average 20 years than they were living in the 90s. Liberia was also able to achieve the MDG-4. Now, as Liberia joins the global and the regional community on a flagship program, Universal Health Coverage, and the SDGs, the establishment of this diagnostic center is a way forward, is a step forward in the health sector. We expect the center to build capacities, provide quality diagnosis that will reduce turnaround time and treatment time for patients. It will support our hospitals, health centers, and clinics. We would like to thank the NASCOP family and all those who supported them for us to achieve this. We look forward to our collective contributions in serving our public. Thank you.
Thank you, Madam Minister. Our special guests, ladies and gentlemen, I have the honor to congratulate and welcome for a remark, Honorable Joel Howard Taylor, President-elect of the Republic of Liberia. Vice President-elect of the Republic of Liberia.
Congratulations, madam.
Thank you for the correction. Her Excellency, Madam Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, our chairperson and members of the board of directors of NASCOP, the DG and his efficient staff, NASCOP family, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, all other protocols duly observed. We are happy to be here this afternoon to witness again another legacy event under the Sirleaf-led government. Madam President, we salute you. We want to thank all of those who were involved in this very critical project, helping to provide accessible health care to our people. Diagnosis is a very important part of the healthcare system because if you do not find out what the problem is, you are misdiagnosed, and sometimes people actually die from taking the wrong medication. Thank you, NASCOP, for this very beautiful idea. We want to thank the doctor from Ghana who's come to help us. We understand there will be Liberian partners in this process. We look forward to engaging you so it is an effective and efficient system that adds value to the healthcare of our country. Thank you. Before I take my seat, listening to Honorable Chris McBorough and the DG talking about the profitability of NASCOP, shareholders of this corporation are the Liberian people. We hope we'll begin to send some of that money back to increase the payment to our people across the country who are retired and are barely living on a bare minimum. As you build these beautiful buildings, may we also increase the input to
social security benefits for our people so they too can grow and enjoy our country. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madam Vice President-elect. You know, the reason I made that mistake, the political people might know, they've always deprived me the right and the privilege to introduce the president. And yesterday, I finally got it. So here we go. Bear with me as I practice maybe to introduce the president for the first and probably the last time. Vice President-elect, Senator Joel Howard Taylor, Senator Kumene B. Wiesett, the chairman and members of the board of directors of NASCAR, the executive governor of the Central Bank, the former director general of NASCAR, here present, the inspector general of the La Brea National Police. Our world deserves beneficiaries, members of the cabinet and government officials here present, special invited guests, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. It is an honor to most respectfully ask you to please rise as we welcome for a special statement, Her Excellency President Ellen Johnson Sirleaf, President of the Republic of Liberia.
Very well, please sit down. Good afternoon. I still haven't been able to convince our protocol officers and those who introduced me, after many others have spoken, to just say we stand on existing protocol. But that's their way. Madam Vice President-elect, thank you for coming to join us. I know your schedule and how busy it is, but taking the time to come for this event, we appreciate that. In the past year or so, we have been talking about some of the things that this administration, this government has achieved, most times in the area of infrastructure, roads, bridges, hospitals, schools, power plants, and all of that. But we always miss an important part of what we think we have achieved, the building and strengthening of institutions. Facilities don't run themselves. They're run by capable institutions who are staffed by capable people. And so today, as we dedicate this facility, I'd like to follow others in applauding NASCO and what they've achieved over the years in strengthening, an important part of which is not only the structures they've supported, but also the plans that they have for investment, and more importantly, the plan for pension to ensure that those who retire, retire in dignity, and that they retire with a living wage. We cannot say we're there yet, but I think the plan that has been formulated will go a long way to meet what I know will be the demand and the requirement of the new administration. We've worked on institution building with the Governance Commission, and I want to just use the opportunity to applaud Dr. Amos Sawyer and what he has done to create all of these
to strengthen them, to help them to formulate the right policies, the right rules, the right accountability and transparency systems, the right monitoring and evaluation systems to ensure that our institutions meet the requirement for which they were created. In our healthcare system, we've also talked about the many things we've done for County Hospital. We've talked about the Jackson Fiado and the state of art that exists in that hospital in Tapita, Nima County. But we also recognize that there were gaps in strategic care that we did not have in the country. One of those was good eye care. And today we're pleased that the gap in that regard has been covered with the state-of-the-art eye care that we now have in collaboration with the John F. Kennedy Hospital. Today, another one of those strategic areas are covered by this diagnosis center, which we have come to dedicate. I want to applaud all of those, as has been done by others who spoke before me, for what they have done to be able to do this. Our partnership institutions in Ghana, our contractors, local contractors, the chairman and board of directors of NASCO, the managing director, and his very able staff. To all of you, we say a big thank you. Whenever I join the managing director to dedicate a facility, I can see right now he's rearing back because he knows I'm coming up with something. Whenever I join him to dedicate one facility, without fail, I gave him another challenge. And so today, Madam Managing Director and your good staff here, we started a project, the relocation of West Point. We've gone a certain ways, and if you go out to VOA in Brewerville, you will see the structures we have started that all have reached the, before the roofing. They've all reached that point. And all they need now is to do the roofing, to finish the structure, so that the many hundreds of people who have signed up for relocation can indeed move. So I urge you, and since I'm sitting there before the vice president-elect herself, who will be vice president in 2 days, I imagine I'm also touching her ears to say that she will join me in calling you to say you can finish those buildings, so those West Point, because the rains are coming again and they will also face difficulty. Thanks to all of you for coming to this event. We're so proud of everything that's happened. We're pleased of the cooperation which we have received, and I want to thank all Liberians for how they have supported this government, how they have held us up. They've enabled us to do that which we have done. We haven't done it all. We have achieved everything that our vision had formulated, but we think we've come a long way, and we thank you for being there with us.
I was tempted and instructed by the president to say stand on existing protocol. So I will say that. I'm charged with closing down this program, which I'm indeed pleased to do so. In this light, a lot of thanks have been extended to a number of different parties, individuals who all participated. I would prefer to break protocol and break from tradition, from the normal vote of thanks where you give a litany of individuals and people and leave a lot of people out. Instead, I will pray your indulgence that we all stand up and give ourselves a hand clap in acknowledgement of the good work all of us have done. Special thanks to all of our invitees for having attended the program, particularly those who also provided us with some insightful statements. Notably, I have two key things which I picked up. One is that of the Vice President,
who pointed out the need to divert and improve the benefits. Madam Vice President, we are mindful of that, and we have, in a solemn and useful way, begun that process by creating a flow, which Madam Salif, honor her encouragement to raise the flow for the above the poverty line for above benefit payments. Today, that flow has been raised to $360 per year. So that nobody gets less than that of the poverty line. More, equally important, I'd like to thank Minister Dan. She didn't know what she was saying, but I caught it, that the life expectancy has improved. So that means I can transfer some of that annuity money to current beneficiaries to improve the lower wage people. So by now we can, Mr. Director General, don't have to be scared that we have too many people qualifying. We have a longer life expectancy. So in that, I tell the Minister Dan for thank you for that information. Let's not delay any longer. Let the project speak for itself. We welcome you to Mr. Twyer, to please lead us into that next process. Yeah. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Mr. Bryce, the Chief Financial Officer of NASCA. The Director General will lead the President and our special guest, the Vice President-elect, you know, the Director General will lead the President and the Vice President-elect to cut the ribbon and tour the building, along with all of our invited guests. Mr. Director.
Where are the scissors?
I don't know where you want to go.